And we are back at this what if. Yay! What's up everybody, AnimeX here, and in this video I'll be adding another part to the What If Naruto Was an Uchiha series. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because I think it'd be beneficial for me to make another part and to you guys to explain what's going on during the 2-year time skip. So with Naruto and Sasuke and Orochimaru's hideout, there will be a light goal for this one, I'm joking. The light goal for this one will just be 800 likes, and you guys will get a part 11 immediately after that. I will be recapping the previous part to this what if, but if you haven't watched the previous part, I do recommend that you go watch those right now. I'll leave a link to that description and in the top right hand corner, because there are major spoilers for this what if ahead. So now that I've given you guys a warning, I'm going to jump right into the recap and into the video. So without further ado, let's get started. Now, in the last part of What If Naruto Was an Uchiha, we saw Naruto go on his journey to go retrieve Sasuke along with the rest of the Sasuke recovery team. After he met Sasuke in the final valley, they fought to a standstill, but instead of Sasuke beating him and leaving him by himself, Naruto decides to leave the village with Sasuke to go train with Orochimaru, get stronger to fight Itachi, and make sure that Sasuke doesn't go too far into the dark side. So that's where we'll be starting this what if off. Now, a couple days after getting to Orochimaru's hideout, Naruto and Sasuke are thrown into the thick of it. Sasuke in particular is being groomed for being Orochimaru's next body, while Naruto is more of a back burner in case of emergencies body. During the times when Sasuke is being trained by Orochimaru, Naruto is honing and working on his own techniques. For one, he's working on being able to make two Chidoris simultaneously, and he attempts to do the same thing with Ultra Sengan. Then, while training on this for days without rest, an idea clicks into Naruto's head, where he attempts to combine the two abilities into one super powerful jutsu. Now, Naruto only does this when he's absolutely sure that no one is watching or monitoring him in any way, or when he's with Sasuke only. He doesn't want to reveal this trump card to Orochimaru until he's completely mastered it, or unless he's doing it in training against Sasuke. Now, as you guys know, when Orochimaru refuses to have anyone that can't be of use to him in any way, shape, or form, or be anywhere near him if they can't be of use or help to him at all. So, he won't help them, and so in order to test their skill, at the end of every week, Naruto and Sasuke must spar with each other in order to demonstrate or show that neither of them are slacking off in their training, and they are both suitable people for Orochimaru's body. And every time they go, the outcome is different. Sasuke usually has the upper hand in the beginning of the fight, but Naruto's quick thinking and his combination, his unusual personality and fighting style, usually nets him a victory every other time. Now, sometimes this training gets especially intense, and that's when Naruto and Sasuke do this training to test their limits for themselves. You can clearly tell the difference between when Naruto and Sasuke are just going through the motions for Orochimaru, or when they're really trying to test their power against each other, and they attempt to absolutely demolish the other in a fight. In those types of fights, Sasuke uses the second Sage Curse Mark, and Naruto forces out one tail in order to match that. And those are the fights that usually end in Sasuke winning, just due to the fact that Naruto's tail activation and the amount of chakra pouring out of his body all depends on the rage that Naruto is feeling at the time. So if Naruto can't force himself to feel this burning anger in his heart, it's very hard to actually match Sasuke in terms of physical stats alone. Naruto realizes that he's progressing at a rate that is much slower than that of Sasuke's, and he knows that he has to be strong enough to illuminate Sasuke's shadow, and I mean this in a metaphorical sense. If you saw the last part, you know what I'm talking about. So Naruto does cave in, and he starts accepting the training with Orochimaru, and slowly but surely, base Naruto is actually increasing in taijutsu, and really every part of being a powerful shinobi. The one thing that he won't cave in on and won't let Sasuke cave on is the drugs that Orochimaru wants to pump into their bodies in order to basically get them stronger faster. Sasuke is fairly reasonable on this point, so he refuses to do that since Naruto told him not to. And with the way that Naruto and Sasuke are basically operating, they're basically achieving balance by kind of being like a yin and yang in a sense. Naruto is the light side, Sasuke is the dark. And in order to achieve perfect balance and harmony like all things should be, it has to be a give and take between them. Naruto realized that training with Orochimaru would get him stronger faster, so he does that. Sasuke knows that putting the drugs in his body might only reap short-term benefits, and they may weaken him later on in his life, so Naruto tells him not to do that, and he compromises on that. Now, while they train with Orochimaru, they do the training for about 8 hours a day, which is very grueling for them. And it really does just consist of taijutsu training, dojutsu training, which is basically training their Sharingan and trying to get better at genjutsu, making the strain of using the 3 tomoe a lot easier, and basically honing their Sharingan to the absolute maximum power efficiency, and also kenjutsu training. After their allotted training time, Naruto and Sasuke go on to do their own things throughout the day. Sasuke works on his lightning style jutsu and variants of the Chidori, since he's more adept at that than Naruto, and Naruto decides to finish working on his new jutsu, which combines the Rasengan and the Chidori. Now, Naruto is essentially attempting to do what Kakashi couldn't do with his move, so Naruto has to use hundreds upon hundreds of shadow clones in order to get the training that he needs to do in order to hone this jutsu. Now, these shadow clones are going at hard work even while Naruto is actually training on other things, which means, you know, he's pretty exhausted all the time. But after 6 months of grueling training, Naruto has finally mastered it, the Rasen Chidori. Naruto forms this by making the Rasengan, and then immediately after this activates the lightning release chakra all over it. Now, due to the spinning nature of the Rasengan, the lightning release on the Rasengan will spin as well. Taking this into account, Naruto then focuses all of this rotation power on the end of the technique to create a sharpened point, making a lightning Rasengan drill. Its destructive abilities is that of Rasengan times the Chidori's, meaning that this can cut by rending through whatever is in its way. This also means that the speed of the jab is less important, and Naruto can basically just form this and stab wherever he wants to at whatever speed he decides to, because Naruto also has the benefits of the Rasengan, although speed does help the power. Naruto can just ramp up the rotational speed for even more devastating power. The only issue is that this takes a ton of chakra even from Naruto, meaning that Naruto only has one use per day. This means that Sasuke and anybody with less chakra than him as a whole can't even hope to make a jutsu on this level of chakra consumption. Now, when Naruto shows Sasuke, Sasuke grins like because he thinks that they both have something that could destroy the near impenetrable armor of Itachi's. They don't know it as Susanoo yet, but they're both aware of the ribcage that Itachi using against them in their fight. Now, Naruto asks what Sasuke's ability is, and Sasuke has to go outside to use his. So when he does, Naruto sees that it's a stormy day, and Naruto wonders why Sasuke would need to go out here to perform a super strong jutsu. Sasuke then lifts his hand and diverts lightning chakra to it and yanks down his hand, and as soon as he does this, a lightning dragon responds by coming out of the sky and striking the earth with such power that the earth seems to shake for a bit. Now, when Naruto looks at the damage from that, he's greatly impressed since that has a greater destructive capability than even his Rasen Chidori. Although Sasuke doesn't seem to be done yet, Sasuke lifts his hand once again and says that he increases Jutsu's power even more. And then, with a harsh whisper, he says, "Twin Lightning Dragon." And then immediately, the Kirin dissipates and another one hits the exact same spot immediately. Sasuke then, as he's falling down, says that they say lightning doesn't strike twice. Well, this one does, and then he falls to his knees and passes out from the strain of forcing another lightning dragon down from the sky, so Naruto takes him back immediately to get, you know, some rest. Naruto and Sasuke then continue on this type of training routinely until the first year passes. Now, when the year anniversary of them leaving the village comes up, Naruto and Sasuke sneak off to go look at everyone in the village. Kabuto, of course, objects to this when he tries to see them try to sneak out, but Naruto and Sasuke just give him a look that exudes a threat behind the glare. Kabuto then just pretends like he didn't see anything, and Naruto and Sasuke head off to the village for a day, and once they bypass the barrier, they sneakily head into the village, and they don't let anyone see them because they wouldn't be allowed to leave if they do so. So, for the day, they just spend their time there in the village, reminiscing on good times they had as a genin, and all the memories that they made there. And for the first time in a year, Sasuke and Naruto are able to crack a genuine smile that feels natural to them. In fact, while in the village, they both feel so emotional that they both shed a single tear, and they strengthen their resolve to fight even more. They want to come back soon, so in order to do so, they need to hurry up and handle their training with Orochimaru, and fight Itachi, and win. As they are thinking though, they almost get found by Neji, who was training with his Byakugan. He then randomly sees two chakra signatures that resemble Naruto and Sasuke's, but when he heads over there to run over and confirm his suspicions, they are gone instantly. And now, the two rogue ninja head back to the hideout with a new resolve, and they are both reminded of why they fight. Now, over the next year, Naruto and Sasuke continue to train and hone their skills to the absolute maximum. Naruto, over the course of the year, starts to befriend Kurama by merely starting conversations with him outside of combat, asking him how his day was, asking him what his name is, you know, simple stuff like that you would do to befriend someone. Naruto starts doing this because when he went back to the village, he saw the strength that having comrades gave him. So instead of him and Kurama being enemies and Naruto, you know, subjugating him to genjutsu, Naruto decides to give out a hand of peace and compassion to Kurama so that it isn't, it isn't at first received, but he stretches out this hand regardless. But throughout Naruto's persistent and repetitively asking and trying to befriend him, Kurama responds every once in a while healing Naruto quicker in his sleep, and also slowly but surely giving Naruto some of his chakra to integrate into his own. Sasuke, meanwhile, is using his anger, hatred, and cold-hearted nature to push his chakra and intensity to a whole new level. His curse marks respond by slowly increasing his base strength to, you know, to the level of his curse marks later. And neither of them are overtly worried about the other's depth into the light or the darkness because they know that once they come together, they will be able to reunite and balance each other out. And before they know it, the year is out, and it's almost time to kill Orochimaru and finally face Itachi. And that, everybody, is where I'm going to end part 10 to the What If Naruto Was an Uchiha. Obviously, you guys love this series, so you guys are going to hit the like goal, but I got two unusual things to say at the end of the video. One, if you're interested in interacting with me more and the community more as a whole, there is a link to my Discord down below. And if you guys want to hit the like goal, instead of making shadow clones, sharing the video actually helps support me more, which I hope you guys want. Obviously, you don't have to do it. I don't mind if you don't, but please, no more shadow clones. If you like the video and haven't already done so, consider subscribing and hitting the bell so you don't miss out on more Naruto Uchiha content. Hope you enjoyed the video, and as always guys, this is AnimeX, signing off.